And we come back to politics. In the battle for control of the U.S. Senate, many expected Missouri would be an easy pickup for Republicans. Gwen Ifill reports on why the seat is now back in play for Democrats.
Remember, get someone to sign up for a shift, and if you would all sign up for one shift a week for the next 6 weeks, we can get this done.
Last August, Democrat Claire McCaskill became one of the luckiest endangered incumbents in the nation.
This election will be close. I can't remember an election for the United States Senate in our state for this seat that wasn't close.
But for McCaskill, who won only narrowly in 2006, close is good. And the latest polls actually show her ahead.
Thank you so much. It's nice to meet you.
But until recently, national Democrats actually expected her to lose.
I give you our next United States Senator, Todd Akin.
That changed when challenger Todd Akin made waves by going on television to declare that rape victims should not be allowed to have abortions because they seldom get pregnant.
From what I understand from doctors, that's really rare. If it's a legitimate rape, the female body has ways to try to shut that whole thing down.
The video went viral, and Akin's national profile soared. But the five-term congressman immediately became a political pariah within his own party, with Mitt Romney, Paul Ryan, and every senior Missouri Republican demanding he get out of the race. Akin apologized, but he didn't drop out, because he says now he is not a quitter.
I've been at gas stations in different places. People come up. I don't know if they're going to hit me or love me. They say, are you Akin? Are you Todd Akin? I go, yes. People say, I'm going to vote for you. Don't you step down. We chose you. We expect you to go and win this race.
Akin is strongly anti-abortion and has made controversial statements before, including in 2008 when on the House floor he derided abortion providers.
You find that along with the culture of death go all kinds of other law-breaking, the not following good sanitary procedure, giving abortions to women who are not actually pregnant, cheating on taxes, all these kinds of things.
McCaskill's campaign ads remind voters of Akin's comments.
On March 16th, Akin said he wants to abolish the minimum wage. On April 21st, said he would eliminate student loans. And on August 19th, Todd Akin said, only some rapes are legitimate. What will he say next?
But McCaskill has her own problems. Romney is well ahead in Missouri, and more than half of the voters here disapprove of President Obama. She says she remains independent of the White House.
I think the president, if he were in Missouri, he would say to Missourians what I hope they know about me, and that is I can be a real pain. I am not somebody that does what he wants me to do at his beck and call. I have said no to him. Doesn't mean I don't support him. It just means that I have a strong, objective record of independence.
Akin is happy to remind voters she voted for both his health care and his stimulus plans.
She's trying to say that she is mainstream, but when you vote with Barack Obama 98% of the time, it's hard to say that with a straight face.
The outcome of this election could hinge on liberal cities like St. Louis, where Claire McCaskill supporters live, or on conservative suburbs like here in St. Charles, deep in Todd Akin's congressional district. As the candidates duke it out for time, money, attention, and enthusiasm, which voters turn out where matters.
Dave Robertson, a political science professor at the University of Missouri, St. Louis, says the topsy-turvy election has cut both ways.
One of the things Akin has been able to do is to really electrify some of the conservative base. But there's a counter movement to that. And the counter movement is he's helped electrify some of the female voters in the state, some of the moderate voters in the state, some of the votes in the key suburbs in this state that are going to determine the outcome of this election. And that's a real disadvantage for him.
Akin is counting on conservatives, homeschooling parents, and evangelicals to rally around his cause.
We don't tell you who to vote for, but I'm going to tell you how to vote.
Reverend Stoney Shaw, pastor of Ferguson First Baptist Church, has known Akin for 25 years.
Some of my family was, you know, my children, Dad, you're not going to support him, are you? And everybody's turning against him. I said, well, there was another guy that everybody turned against, Jesus Christ, but he prevailed. And I believe Todd will prevail. I really do. He's a good man. Yes, did he misspeak on that issue? Yeah. Yeah, of course he did. But he asked for forgiveness.
Linda Becker, who lives in Akin's district and considers him a friend, thinks it's time to move beyond the rape remarks. Becker dabbles in singing pop and gospel, even on occasion with Akin. And last week was on stage at Oktoberfest in St. Charles. She says she doesn't like the idea of Washington politicians dictating Missouri's choice.
Todd stayed in, and I am so proud of him for staying in and sticking with us, because there are a lot of people that really want Todd in the U.S. Senate, and he's answering that by staying in and fighting.
Has that been very appealing to people, the idea that he resisted all these calls for him to drop out?
Yes, it's very appealing. People like the fact that he's standing up to the powers that be.
Both candidates are betting big on two things, that their supporters will turn out and that their opponents will stay home. Cheryl Hibbler was also at the St. Charles Festival, but she's been working for McCaskill.
I think Claire is a strong woman, strong convictions. She tried to work both sides, but we get the reaction from the persuasion people that we're calling that they don't want to vote for Claire McCaskill because they think that she is too much connected to President Obama. But when we talk about it and they find out more about who Todd Akin is, they seem to say, I can't vote for either one of them. And a non-vote is pretty much an assistance to Claire.
But after Akin refused to get out of the race, and as national Republicans began to worry the Missouri seat might cost them control of the Senate, some Akin critics, including Senator Roy Blunt, have returned to the fold. Still, the party rift remains. Former Republican Senator John Danforth, a force in the St. Louis community, said he would rather write in a candidate than support Akin.
I can understand their position. I mean, it's like counting apples, you know. They're saying, well, we need, you know, 50 or 51 in the Senate, and he's one person who's competing for a seat. But I see him as the apple that spoils the barrel. I mean, that's the way I look at Akin. I think that he really hurts the Republican brand, and he damages the party nationally, and that it's very important for Republicans to say no.
In the front, I say it on the back.
Akin says he'll settle for support from Republicans out of state, including former presidential candidates Mike Huckabee, Rick Santorum, and Newt Gingrich, and even Pat Boone. All that has left both McCaskill and Akin fighting for the middle, with McCaskill condemning Akin as extreme.
He believes that a rape victim should not be able to get emergency contraception. That's a fundamental core belief he has. He believes that the federal government should not tell employers that they are limited in terms of how they can discriminate against women. It's not that we're on opposite ends. It's just he's so far from the middle.
We did go head-to-head today.
For Akin, who caused a new stir when he said McCaskill had not been very ladylike during their last debate, it is the incumbent senator who is out of touch with the state's values.
Let's talk about the mainstream thinking in the state of Missouri. You take a look at the Second Amendment in the state of Missouri, that's a freedom people respect, the right to bear arms. I have an A rating from the NRA. She has an F rating. Now, which is mainstream?
McCaskill has one clear advantage. With under a month to go, she has far more cash in her campaign war chest, while outside PAC money has stopped flowing into Akin's campaign. And barring new controversy, that, as much as anything, may determine who gets the last word.
The full interviews with Todd Akin and Claire McCaskill are online. Plus, get Gwen's take on how Romney's post-debate rebound might play out in the Missouri Senate race. That's in her weekly blog post on our politics page.